many of them, okay, just to, you know, get your gigs back. You are not Fiverr customer care now, come on, you are not Fiverr customer care. So it's not a must that when you do all these things, but you know, you have 70% chance of, you know, getting back on the search engine if you do all those stuff. Okay, so that aside, when you have, you know, that other drops, when the others are not coming, but you know, in the past month, in the past week, you had others, what do you do? Okay, so here I've been in that situation, I've been in that shoe. Okay, so I'm not just, you know, telling you folk tales or telling you one cock and bull story. No, I'm telling you what I've been doing when, you know, my gig stopped ranking and when I had no, you know, messages coming and when the Fiverr buyers requests are dry. This is what I do. Okay, like from time to time, I always tell you, Fiverr is more like a business, okay? So you had customers, right? You had customers in the past. You had people that bought gig for you, and the mistake most of you make is when the others are forthcoming, you know, you just do a one-time gig for some customers and disappear. You don't communicate anymore. Once he gives you the review, once he gives you the, you know, he marks your order complete, you just disappear, no communication again. So it doesn't work that way. So this strategy, like I'm about revealing, is more like a customer seller relationship. Okay, so if you keep close relationship with your customers, you deliver quality value, and you know, keep in constant communication with the person that you previously offered a gig to, definitely in your draw days, like in your those periods that you're not getting orders, if you send a message, you know, asking after their well-being, how are they doing and all that, telling them that you are available for gigs, definitely. If you send like welfare messages to about 7 of your, you know, past buyers, definitely. Let's say if 5 are active, still active on Fiverr, 4 of them will, you know, reply you and definitely, you know, place an order with you. Okay, so what I'm trying to say is this: you had past customers in the past, okay? So like you're a writer and you've written an ebook for a customer, and after the customer marks the order complete, try to be in constant communication with the person, you know, asking after their well-being. Most especially, I made a post on Facebook saying that if you're a Fiverr seller, okay, and this is COVID-19, and you know that your customer was, you know, affected, lives in those most affected areas, most especially USA, South America, and all those, you know, top world countries, you should send them a message asking about their well-being. Okay, it's not rocket science. This is more like a psych. This is more like you are checking up on your customer, your regular customer. If you are in Ladebo or if you are in, you know, Balogun Market in Lagos, you know, from time to time, people check on their customers. So this is what you are going to do. There are dry days on Fiverr that you won't even see any others to do. And that's like most Fiverr sellers' nightmares. Okay, so this is what you have to do. After you complete each and every project on Fiverr, okay, try to, you know, a week after, check on the persons you delivered the order. If you designed a website for someone, you should check on them, okay? Like ask them how are they doing, how is their website, how is the business doing, okay? Just ask them so that when, you know, time comes for you to, you know, check on them and tell them that you are available for gigs, that you can, you know, comfortably with clear conscience do that, okay? So this is where I'm driving at. The image you are seeing on the screen is just, you know, a random message I sent to some of my customers, okay? A random message I sent to some of my customers during the pandemic, I think so. And this message, this single message, you see the reply I got. It's been up to a year I did a gig with this person, but because I sent that welfare, you know, to check up on this person, you see the reply I gave. The reply he gave was that, okay, I have a new website too, I want you to work on. Please check it and, you know, let me know the price. You see, and trust me, I'll even, you know, make an update video on this. Trust me, this is going to order a gig from me, definitely. And not just that, if you check, there is this image here. I have, you know, 10 orders from a single buyer. Just check, look at this image. I have a 10 gigs like from a single buyer, and I have, you know, up to more than 500 buyers on Fiverr. So this is just to show you, like, they keep on coming back for more. If you use this strategy, I'm going to tell you, like, it's more like a customer, you know, relationship, so that when the orders are not forthcoming, you have, you know, returning customers. So as I said, I don't want this video to be too long, but you know, you get the picture I'm trying to paint. What I'm trying to say is that if you finish a gig on Fiverr, check on this person, you know, send messages, know how they're faring, know how they are doing, so that when your orders are not forthcoming, you have your returning customers with you. It's not rocket science. Okay, I've been doing this for, you know, for some time, and it's been working for me. All right, so I'll stop the video here. I hope you got value for this video. If you did, kindly smash that red subscribe button and also the like button so that, you know, you tell YouTube this video is very informative to you. All right, and to end this video, if you found this video informative, I have a free ebook for you. So just comment with hashtag Fiverr. Just comment hashtag Fiverr and I'll send that free ebook to you. It's very an invaluable ebook on Fiverr that will help you, you know, make sales on Fiverr. All right, so this is me, Tony, signing out, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.